Welcome, Michel Poletti, President of International Trail Running Association from the beginning till last Saturday. It's been a huge trip, 7 years, and I very much appreciate that you take your time to talk to us from Chamonix. How does it feel at Chamonix with the confinement these days?
It's not the worst place. So thank you hello to you, Sergio, and hello to all the people who will listen this this tape. Confinement here in Chamonix, yes, it's like in all Europe, but to be confined in such a place than Chamonix, I feel very lucky with comparison with all other people in the big cities. So it's not a so bad place for that.
Well, actually, I'm talking to you 50K from Madrid at Cercedilla. We are at the Guadarrama National Park. I open my window. I see the mountains up to 2,500 meters, the Peñalara Peak. But we are not allowed to go out of home. I understand that in Paris, for example, after 19 hours, runners are still allowed to go run out. How is it in Chamonix? You are allowed to go out and walk, stroll, run?
We here in France, we can go outside the home for just 1 hour maximum, and in a circle of 1 kilometer maximum around our home, for walking or jogging or running, and so here in Chamonix, I'm still able to go on some trails just close to my house.
You lucky man.
Absolutely.
Okay, we will devote this day to your ITRA balance, those 7 years. But before that, there's a question that I must put forward, Michel. You understand? Because everybody listening to us is saying, well, is there going to be UTMB 2020?
That's a good question. Honestly, we don't know. Honestly, we don't know, because for all people here in Europe, we are all speaking about the end of confinement, how it will be, how long it will be. And so just impossible the only thing we know is that if we can organize, we are our best option for sure is to keep the event at the end of August. It will be for sure not the same event as usual. We know that not all runners will be able to fly and to come here in Europe. So we are working hard to keep the event, and it will be a special event, but we don't know, and we are also working on all the other possibilities, maybe to postpone a little bit. It will be very difficult, but maybe to postpone a little bit, or if we are obliged to cancel. It's impossible to give a clear answer now, and I think we'll give a clear answer in several weeks, but right now we are just working on all the possibilities and to be ready to keep the one. Yeah, the best one is for sure to keep the event, but we don't know if it will be possible, so we need to wait.
Okay, because in the history of Chamonix, I think there are three people who have had quite a relevant effect. As for the general public, the one Horace Benedict de Saussure, when he offered, you know, the award to the first man to step on Mont Blanc, he's got a statue. The second, Roger Prison-Roche, the novelist and the adventurer and the mountain guide. Saussure was from Geneva. Rocher was from Beaufort. They ended up filling Chamonix. But when you and Catherine created UTMB, you are a Chamonix. So how does it feel to have turned Chamonix on the first weekend of September from the weekend where the hotels closed. I still remember going to UTMB in 2008 and having to negotiate because my hotel was closing, whereas the most important weekend of the year. How does it feel?
It feels very good. It feels very good. And we are very proud with Catherine of what is right now the UTMB event at the end of August each year here in the Mont Blanc area, because yes, I was born in Chamonix, but more important, it's not only Chamonix, it's really the Mont Blanc area and Courmayeur and the Switzerland and all the village and around the Mont Blanc. Yes, we are very proud of this, we are over famous people and not only Saussure and Frison Roche, we are all, and for example, Whymper. So you have people from England who came from the very first alpinism, and we have plenty of people here in Chamonix. It's a wonderful city, and
Okay. In the beginning, it was the UTMB. Then the 5th of September of 2012 at Courmayeur, there was a first seminal meeting for International Trail Running Association. But I think you should share, you know, how UTMB came to be, because you were a runner basically, and you were into running, but 1 year, it was not possible to do the race that you were registered for. So you chose to create something using the classic Tour de Mont Blanc route, a trekking route, which is, hosts about 250,000 trekkers every year. People had not really thought about doing it on a single. And if I remember correctly, there were Michelle and Catherine at a small fair promoting this original different race when an American called Topher Gaylord came along. What happened? Because that's history.
So you are speaking of the beginning of UTMB.
Yes.
It can be a very long story. The beginning of UTMB is just to follow an old race was around Mont Blanc during the 90s, and it was a relay race, and this race stopped because of a big accident in the Tunnel du Mont Blanc in 1999. And the race stopped for 3 years, and in 2002 the race was not able to restart, to be reorganized. And here in Chamonix, I was part of a running club here in Chamonix, and the president of the running club was saying, "Oh, it's bad. It was a nice race. We need to do something." And we spoke inside the club, and Catherine and I was part of this running club, and with the president and with other people. The president is René Bachelard. Other people, I need to speak about Jean-Claude Marmier, who was very important in the story of UTMB. We decided to create this new race all around the Mont Blanc, non-stop, just running, walking all around the Mont Blanc. And yes, you are right. For the first year, we signed our first sponsorship agreement with the North Face, and at this time, the general manager of the North Face here in Europe and for all Middle East was Topher Gaylord, and Topher Gaylord was for who know Topher is still. But he was a very, very strong runner, and he was part of his first adventure, and he finished second together with Brandon. Brandon, I forgot his name, family name, Siborski. And the first was for sure Dawa Sherpa, who won the first UTMB, and Topher was our sponsor, finished second of the first edition of UTMB in 2003.
It was a success from the start. Great runners, great atmosphere. It developed very fast. So in 2006, there came the second of the family, second children, CCC. I was a very lucky man when in 2008, together with Eric Fournier, who was then the mayor of Chamonix, we ran the 100 kilometers of CCC. Then in 2009, there came the TDS. So there were the three girls in the family. And in fact, I have been very lucky. I was able to finish CCC 2008, UTMB 2013, and TDS 2016. Three girls, very different characters. But before I was able to finish a UTMB in 13, there were three terrible years, which is 2010, 2011, 2012, very difficult years. But in 2012, after that year, on the 5th of September 12th, another new project was born. It's if I remember correctly, there were about 150, how do you say in English, stakeholders,
yeah. You know,
people interested of different brands, race directors, runners, institutions that got together in Courmayeur, and there was a decision to go on split in, if I remember, five working groups. And thus was the origin of ITRA. At that time, there already existed, if I remember correctly, Skyrunning World Series and the World Mountain Running Association and IAU, International Association of Ultra Running. Why, for people like you, which were among the founding fathers, let's say, did you feel there was a need for a different project?
Because at that time, all what you said is perfectly exact, perfectly true. Why did we organize, and did I organize, I was the main organizer of this first big meeting for Mayer, just following the UTMB in 2012. And yes, it was very difficult to organize this meeting because 2012 was also a very difficult year for UTMB with bad weather, with many things to change at the last minute. But anyway, why did we organize this big meeting in Courmayeur? Because at that time, we saw that trail running was growing up and going in several directions. It was the year where scale running was another sport. Scale running was born in Italy as a real mountain and technical mountain races. And in 2012, they came in the trail running world by creating a new international circuit. And at that time also, we saw that brands were talking on their own, thinking about how can the sport can be organized for the elite athletes. We had this idea that it could be better for all these people just to talk together. And the very original idea was only simply to gather people, to let people talk together instead of having someone in one side, another one on another side. The original idea was just, okay, guys, we are all interested by trail running. Just gather together and talk together. That was the very original idea of ITRA.
Then out of those 150 people involved, basically, we can say that 15 people got more deeply involved, which are acknowledged as permanent members of ITRA or founding fathers, whatsoever. But if we take note of that list, there's a clear majority of race directors. And ever since, ITRA has had in its steering committee, which is the collegiate group that officially manages ITRA together with its president, there's always been a majority. If I remember correctly, Michelle, as of 2020, 7 years after, out of the 17 positions in the steering committee, there's still 10 people who are race directors. Some people believe that ITRA is more accurately described as a race director organization rather than as a let's say, transversal platform because of its origin and because of the management. Was that something that it was sought after from the beginning, or was it something that evolved because race directors got more involved than other? For example, national federations were invited, but World Athletics specifically requested that they stayed outside.
Yeah. So Maya, if we come back in 2012, my original idea was together organizers. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I spoke of that idea, it was during a French meeting in the French Federation of Athletics in Paris. As soon as Hervé Simon, who is another founder member of ITRA, said, Michel, don't make the mistake to gather all only organizers. We need to gather all people. Mm-hmm. And that was the real goal we put for the meeting in Courmayeur, to gather all people. Organizer, runners, media, institution, IAU, French Federation of Athletics, and Skyrunning was also there. And it was the real original idea. And the first statutes we had for ITRA was to have different several kinds of membership, runners, organizers, institutions, companies, and we tried really at the very first to do this together, all people. We saw with time going on, and we saw that it was difficult to keep inside the same association all these people, and. For example, the big thing, there are two main categories who are not anymore inside ITRA, was the brands, companies, brands, and the institutions. The brands, I talked with Jean-Marc Pambet, CEO of former CEO of Salomon. It was, don't remember, 2014 maybe, and he said, okay, maybe we could go in another way, because for example in the ski world you can see that the brands are inside their own association talking mm-hmm. with the with the International Federation mm-hmm. of Ski. And as it was not easy to welcome brands, welcome company in ITRA, we thought that it was a good thing, yes, to say to the brand, yes, it's a good idea. You can make your own association, and then this association of all the brands will be able to talk with ITRA. That was the original idea when Kilian for Salomon organized a meeting here in Chamonix during the UTMB week. But unfortunately, they never did this. They never made this association. But it was not anymore the problem of ITRA, it was their problem of the brands. The other question is the relationship with the institution. We thought that it was a good thing to welcome institution, to welcome the National Federation of Athletics inside the ITRA, and we did this because we wanted, as said, we wanted to have in ITRA all people interested in the trail running. But at the same time, we were working very closely with IWF, with now World Athletics. And we were trying to find the best way to work with them. And at the same time, they were also reorganizing themselves. I am speaking of the year 2015 and later on. 2015 is the year where Sébastien Coe has been elected as president of IWF. And it's the same year that IWF recognized trail running as being fully part of the athletics. But the IWF reorganized their own strategy and became, and they are now World Athletics. And working with them, we decided together with them to reorganize ITRA without the National Federation of Athletics being part of ITRA, because IWF asked us to and said, okay, it's our job to have the relationship with the National Federations of Athletics, that's our part, that's the part of IWF. And your part, ITRA, will be to gather organizers and runners and to be our partner for the trail running worldwide. And that's exactly what we did last year in 2019 by making a new version of our statutes in which we reduced the membership with the two main parts in the trail running community. These two main parts are organizers and runners, and we canceled the membership of National Federation of Athletics because we were asked and we agreed, we were asked for that by IWF, but we agreed with that. And that's why we arrived with the current statutes of ITRA, in which we have the two main parts of the trail running community, which are organizers and runners. And to come back to your question, right now, we have 17 people in the steering committee with three founding members. It doesn't matter if these founding members are runner or organizer, it doesn't matter. They are founding members, they are representatives.
Excuse me, but that's like having senators for life.
Yes,
but there will be founding members for life. And out of those 15 people, there are three slots in the steering committee. Is that correct?
Yeah, because we fund it, we agree on the fact that to have the founding members represented, it was important to keep the spirit, to keep the original idea, the original spirit, the values that we put at the very beginning. It was important to have people representing that in the steering committee, and we have 8 organizers and 6 runners.
Mm-hmm. Do you believe that eventually those senators for life will not be necessary anymore?
It's no more. It's
your personal opinion. Obviously, you are not the president anymore.
Yes, I am not the president anymore. I think Petra will have to make a choice because I think that the current statutes are just an intermediate statutes, and that ITRA will need to continue to develop and to continue to adapt their statutes, and it will be to the new steering committee, to the steering committee, but I am not anymore in it. To the steering committee to decide if they want to give to still give a strong place to the founding members, or to cancel them and to stay with just organizers and runners. Anyway, I can't answer this question because it's not anymore my role.
Okay. Now, in 2015, I was direct eyewitness to a new development, which is the first world championship at Annecy, whereas the French took the gold, Luis Alberto took the silver. It was a wonderful race from the sporting point of view, but technically speaking, it was, let's say, kind of controversial because the sport of running in the mountains had a world championship from 1985, organized by World Mountain Running Association, which is still ongoing. Let's say from the athletics point of view and from the mountaineering point of view, since 1995, there was a world championship by skyrunning. True enough, none of them were reaching up at ultra distances at 2015. Well, maybe some skyrunning races. Why did ITRA choose to partner with IAU, which had never done off-road running, rather than partner with sky running or world mountain running to bring about that new world championship?
Because first, IAU was organizing the Trail World Championship since 2007.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very little race in somewhere in United States. They reorganized a Trail World Championship in 2009 in Serre Chevalier, France, more known event. With Thomas Leblanchet as the winner of this World Championship. And they reorganized the Trail World Championship in 2011 and 2013, both in UK.
Mm-hmm.
We were not happy with how was organized these Trail World Championships. But it was a Trail World Championship. And on the other part, you are speaking of Sky Running Championship or Mountain Championship. That is not exactly the same thing. And the question is that ITRA is the International Trail Running Association. That's why we thought that it was a good thing to promote the Trail World Championship and to try to clarify what was skyrunning, and what is skyrunning, and what is also mountain running? And it's a difficult task. It's a difficult task because there is obvious overlaps on all these running sports in the nature, in the mountains. So, but it was just obvious that sky running was not trail running, and mountain running was not trail running, and trail running is the biggest part of the sport right now. It was not the case 20 years ago, but right now, trail running is much more big than sky running or than mountain running, and needs to have, in my opinion, needs to have its own world championship. And we knew that IAU was not the good partner for that, but it was a fact that they were organizing because IAU is for ultra running, and they said, okay, more than 42 kilometers, we can organize the Trail World Championship. So they start with the agreement with the patronage of IWF. They started to organize these races, and we help them the best we can to organize these races. And we were very happy with the new project with IWF, with World Athletics, the new project of the new Mountain and Trail World Championship. The first edition will be next year in 2021. And we thought that it was a good thing for IWF, for World Athletics, to gather together the mountain running and the trail running, were very close, but there are their own specificities. Mountain running is very more short race, but it's not exactly the same way of organizing, and not exactly the same kind of races than trail running races. And with this new 2021 Mountain and Trail World Championship, I saw the question of the overlap between the long mountain world championship and the short trail race being in the same event, just one race of more or less 40-45 kilometers will be what was the long mountain race or the short trail race. We can have just one race with all the athletes on the same race. So that was our way to develop trail running worldwide.
Yeah. Well, I think we all agree, Michel, that having a unified 2021 World Championship for World Athletics with four events, the uphill, the classic, the marathon, and the ultra 80K will be wonderful. Obviously, it will now most probably have to be after the Olympics, so somewhere in the autumn or winter, because having it before the Olympics, it will be kind of difficult for plenty of federations. However, in the way up to this 2021, ITRA, if I remember correctly, and help me, because we both were present at Annecy, then it was Peneda Gerês in Portugal, then it was Badria Pataglia in Italy, then it was Peña Golosa, and it was like up. It was wonderful championships, great fights, but the 19 edition was kind of controversial because after having France, Portugal, Italy, Spain, ITRA chose to go back to Portugal and to do it with a course that is usually Trillos de Sabutres, run in winter, and it's part of the charm and atmosphere of Trillos de Sabutres, but it was moved specifically to summer to accommodate the championship, and instead of being a 50 or an 80K race, it was a 42K race. Do you think it was the best choice now looking back, or maybe it would have been better to try to broaden and move out of Southern Europe?
Yes, it was the objective was to have the my feeling is that I worked hard for several years to have both the federal world and the private world well represented for in trail running. What I want to say, I can take the example of cyclism. In cyclism, you have both a very important and very well organized world championship, and you have also Tour de France, or Giro, or Vuelta. You have both federal and private worlds who are well represented. In trail running, the private world is obvious, and I am representing by my UTMB side, I am representing this private world, but the federal world is still very poor. Mm-hmm. Still very poor. And what we tried to achieve by proposing Annecy, Maxires, and then over Peñagolosa, that was good because we were inside big events. But the other events, even in Badia, it was nice, but it was a small event. And last year in Portugal, it was also two small events. But we were not able to with IAU, it was not possible to go on. And what I expect is that with World Athletics, it will be possible to reach on the federal side of the sport to a very big event.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so basically, these 7 years at ITRA have been a success story. It's true that in the beginning, you got inspiration from plenty of sources. For example, the American Trail Running Association, President Nancy Hobbs, which is also a council member of a World Council member for World Mountain Running, did exchange and share with back in 2014 some insight on how they were self-funding themselves, like generating revenue from runners, from race directors, from different partners. And that was the same structure that was implemented by ITRA. How important do you think it has been that ITRA has generated substantial revenue streams and has been able to have real financial resources, which are arguably probably larger than ISF for skyrunning or mountain running or IAU?
I'm not sure to have perfectly well understood your question, but I will try to answer it.
How do you achieve a sustainable development without generating revenue streams? It's impossible. Yeah, part of the success, I think, is that these are solid revenue streams.
Yeah. But we spoke a lot about there are two sides in ITRA, and we spoke quite a lot about the federal side, about the World Championship. And it's important, and it's important to for ITRA to have a clear position on that side. But the most important side, in my opinion, a former president of ITRA, but the most important side is what we can provide to organizers and to runners to help them in the sport. And it's very simple. We can try as an international association to provide services, the best services we can for organizers and for runners. And these services to be developed they need to be in some way sell. We need to sell them to the, and to sell in an association is just to say, okay, you can be member of the association. Being member of the association, you will get the service, and you will be able to participate in the association. You will have the vote right for voting for the election of the association. That's very simple. But yeah, it's just the question that we want to gather all the community and to provide the best services to this community.
Also, I think it's fair to note, Michel, that in the beginning, when ITRA was not that, let's say, rich or resourceful, UTMB supported it with staff with shared workloads and shared payments, with technical resources. If I had to put an amount to that, I would probably go over 100,000 euro. The value of the direct financial or economic or people support that UTMB provided. In fact, some of those original members, which were 50-50 funded, have gone on, like Megan, to become the CEO at ITRA these days. In the future, as far as I understand, some of those members, which came originally from Chamonix, from UTMB, will also be coming back to UTMB. Do you think? No?
I've not
understood. Let me know what your plans are, because that's a, let's say, your personal team. It's the people that you have been working for on a daily basis.
There is a mistake. UTMB and with Catherine, we have been happy to help ITRA to develop.
Mm-hmm.
And we provide
100,000? 200,000?
It's not the question here to say a number. Anyway, we were happy with Catherine to provide to help as much as we could to help ITRA to develop, because ITRA was just for me a question of passion. And yes, we welcome in UTMB office the ITRA team, but it was not the UTMB team working for ITRA. There is a big misunderstanding. It's just that ITRA began with just me working, and then some two or three other volunteers, and then we hired a trainee, an intern, and this intern, we had no office for him, and then we said, okay, you can come in the UTMB office, and that's all. So we were happy with Catherine to provide help ITRA to develop, and that's all. After that, ITRA now needs, is ITRA a rich association? That's your world. It's not my world. ITRA.
Annual budget, Michel, would you please? I don't remember by heart. I know it's public, but I don't remember by heart.
No, but.
It's 500,000 or 600,000 euros. I don't remember by heart.
It's no more my role to give you this number. You will ask the new president. And anyway, yes, ITRA has developed a lot. ITRA provide services that organizers and runners are happy to get by becoming members of ITRA. That's very good. And that's all.
Okay. As you say, sometimes it's not well understood outside. In example, we both remember a bitter moment back in 2017. Actually, in 2017, things seemed to be going great. You know, we had the Badia Pataglia Championship coming up. You had just announced the launch of the UTMB International project with Gao Ligong, The announcement was on April the 8th in 2017. But then on June 26th, there came an article in a magazine saying, signed by 9 race directors from the States, the most relevant being Hard Rock and Run Rabbit and Speed Goat 50, claiming that it was unfair that they were being, if I remember correctly, Michel, that they were being charged by ITRA to deliver UTMB points. And obviously, there was some, I mean, big misunderstanding or big confusion there. You chose to answer officially from ITRA. Why officially from ITRA? Because I do remember we discussed at that time how, when, what to answer. And you chose to answer with a official press release by ITRA. If you would like to remember, why from ITRA, not from UTMB? And what were the main points that you were making there? Because I think I do have the communicate here, but I think it's good that you just come up, just to prevent any further misunderstanding on this.
Yeah. What I remember, I'm not sure to remember any detail, but what I remember, it was a dispute against ITRA and not against UTMB. That's why I answered as ITRA president. In my opinion, they misunderstood what was really ITRA, and to be honest, we had the same kind of arguing in France at the very beginning of ITRA in 2014. And then we have this kind of dispute with some race director in US. I did not remember, but if you say it was in 2017, you were right. I think that by being UTMB director and the main person who wanted ITRA to exist, and putting the giving to ITRA some means from UTMB to help ITRA to develop, the association, I can understand that this was not perfectly clear for all people of what was ITRA and what was doing ITRA in a complete independent way from UTMB. I just need to say again that ITRA is an association with a steering committee elected by national representatives elected by ITRA members, and a steering committee elected by the national representative, and a president elected inside the steering committee. So it's a full democratic association, and I've been elected as president until I decided to resign 1 week ago. I close this part, but I think it is very important to say that. To come back to the dispute, I can understand that being ITRA president and a UTMB race director at the same time can make some confusion. And I think that we arrived at the point where we are right now, today, and that the fact that I will stay just as UTMB, involved in UTMB and no more ITRA president, will help people to understand that these two entities are clearly separate, clearly independent, one from each other.
Okay. Now, if I check history, remember, 5th of September 2012, ITRA is born in Courmayeur, and then exactly 1 year after, 5th of September 13, do you remember what happened in a press conference in Chamonix? Another project, another global project was born, announced. Remember, Anton Kruprivka was there with us.
For sure, because you are speaking of Ultra Trail World Tour.
Yeah, maybe.
For sure. And obviously, I remember that because I was highly involved in these two projects. And maybe I will answer to the question before you ask the question. But I was not comfortable at that time. I was not comfortable with a sky running position who was organizing an international circuit of trail running races, because it was not sky running races, it was trail running races. And saying at the same time that it was a world championship. It was a sky running championship. It was not clear because it was a circuit of trail with a title of sky running world champion. Mm-hmm. My idea at that time was to make things clear and to organize ITRA at a true independent and democratic association, mm-hmm. International Trail Running Association, and on the other side, to have UTMB involved in a private circuit. Mm-hmm. This private circuit was Ultra Trail World Tour, in which we took care not using the world World Championship, mm-hmm. because we thought that the world World Championship needed to be in the public side and not mm-hmm. in the private side.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's as well why you chose not to create, let's say, another World Cup with World Cup, because the Mountain Running World Cup has existed for 22 editions.
Yes, but the Mountain World Cup is organized by WMRA, who is a true public association. Mm-hmm. The fact is that skyrunning it is not anymore the case, but was playing on both sides of being a federation and organizing something was clearly a private circuit. It was, in my opinion, it was not clear. Their position right now in 2020 is clear.
Okay. Yes, because now we have the ISF, which organizes the championships, let's say, and then we have a Skyman SA, which is handling the Skyrunner World Series.
Exactly. Right?
So if we move on forward with the Ultra Trail World Tour, as of the current steering committee, we've got in the steering committee of ITRA, there is Michelle, which is UTMB. Then it's Alan, which is the 100 Istria Miles. Then it's Cristina, which is Lavaredo. There is Fernando, which is Trans Gran Canaria. There is Janet, which is Vibram Hong Kong 100. And there is Mario, which is Azores Trail Run. There's a great correlation between the steering committee. I think I mentioned six people. And the Ultra Trail World Tour members. And I think back in March 2019, is it correct that there was a change in the board of administration of Ultra Trail World Tour? And if I remember correctly, when I checked with the Swiss Mercantile Registry in the board of administrators of Ultra Trail World Tour, it's Catherine, it's Michel, it's Rémi Duchemin, and it's the secretary. Is that correct? And when did you take the decision to, step into the board of administrators? And can you tell us any detail about it?
I'm afraid that this discussion can be very confusing for people who listen, because we are speaking of ISRA, we are speaking of UTMB, we are speaking of UTWT, and we need really to take care to be very clear. I think it would be better to have separate discussion. What I can tell is that with Catherine, we have been strongly involved in the creation of Ultra Trail World Tour in 2013, as well as in the creation of ITRA. I already explained that we wanted to make things very clear. But yes, we were from the beginning with Catherine, we were fully involved in Ultra Trail World Tour. And part in the creation of the Swiss company, and there is no change at that point. But once again, we need to be very careful to make the subjects very clear, separate one from the other.
Okay, point taken. So one thing is ITRA, one thing is which is public, one thing is UTMB, another thing is Ultra Trail World Tour. And obviously, we all feel very sensitive about using the expression World Championship. So how did you feel when back in 2018, Adidas created something that they called Infinite Trail World Championship? And furthermore, in 2020, Spartan Trail created something that they called the Spartan Trail World Championship. Is there anything that can be done? Because talking about confusing.
When Adidas created this race, Infinite Trail World Championship, I spoke at that time as ITRA president. I spoke with IWF, and I asked them to do something with their lawyers to say to Adidas that they can't use this word. The answer of IWF was very clear. Anyone in the world can use the word World Championship. Anyone.
Okay.
If you want, in your garden, you can organize a World Championship of what you want.
Okay.
Anyone in the world can organize the World Championship of what he wants. And they had a smart IWF as a smart reflection, and they said, okay, it's just up to us to organize a better world championship than the championship that we have in front of us. The fact is that this organization of the Adidas Infinite Trail World Championship, we don't know them. They are, in my knowledge, they are not part of ITRA.
Mm-hmm.
So it's up to them to do what they want.
Mm-hmm.
And it's up to ITRA to do what they want.
Okay.
And it's just like this. The question with Spartan is not the same.
Mm-hmm.
The question is with Spartan is that you have a new circuit with the name of the circuit is Spartan Trail World Championship. Spartan Trail World Championship. And at the same time, you have organizers of this new circuit being part of ITRA. So it's not the question of Spartan to have a right or no to give this name and to use this word for his circuit. It's the question of the position of organizers who are part of this circuit and part of ITRA. And I just said that this is an issue that has to be solved inside ITRA.
Okay. Meanwhile, of course, this global development by Ultra Trail World Tour and by UTMB has helped many runners discover different ways of racing. An example, you and me, we both shared in 2016 Lavaredo Ultra Trail 120 kilometers. Yes. And off camera, we were saying before that we finished almost at the same time, even though you are more than 10 years my senior. how does it feel to be able to still, you know, put on a bib? Because if I remember correctly, you have also run Gauligan, you have also run Oman recently. How does it feel? Because I remember the first years I traveled to Chamonix and I ran like CCC 2008 or other races. You were there with us. You were running. and I think until 2010. Is that correct?
It is correct. And to be honest, I think it's part of my decision to resign as my role of president of ITRA because I am 65 right this year. I am 65. And I tried for a big number of years. I tried to do everything as well as I could. But one thing is that always tried to stay a runner and to take part in races. But it is a fact that getting older, it's difficult to do everything at the same time. And in your life, you arrive at a time, at a moment where you have to make some decision. And I want to stay involved at 100% in. I cannot stay in. I have been involved at 100% in both ITRA and UTMB side, as well as UTWT, and trying also to be a runner. But I arrived at an age where I need to slow down a little bit, and. I am at the very beginning of all this story. I am a runner, and I want to stay a runner. And that's part of also my decision to stay a runner and to have more time also to enjoy when we will be deconfined, when this crazy thing of COVID-19 will disappear. To be able also to go in the mountains and to train and to run, to continue to run. And you know that we are also working hard to develop UTMB at international level. And at the same time, with Catherine, we have our children, and it's also a question of transmission of all what we did to our children. So it's enough for me, and that's part of the reasons why I decided to resign from ITRA.
Well, so that brings two questions to me. Number one, I fully understand you. As an editor, I have the same conflicting feelings that I'm a runner, but I'm an editor. But so, obviously, as within ITRA, as within mountain running, every member of the steering committee or the World Council is a volunteer position. I think it's important that we mention this, because some people may believe that there is some direct economic compensation. There is not, neither at ITRA nor at World Mountain Running. It is true that there is staff that is, of course, they have salaries and wages, but not, let's say, the top management. However, nevertheless, you have been, Michel and Catherine, arguably the most successful businessmen within the off-road running community in the world, arguably. And why not, now that you are responsible for franchises such as Ultra Trail Mont Blanc Chamonix, by UTMB, or Ultra Trail World Tour, why not bring it together and sell out to, like, the Wanda, the Chinese group that bought the Ironman brand on the 26th of March within the current. Wanda Sports sold Ironman for $730 million to Condé Nast, a content group, an editorial group. Might be the future, I don't know.
Your question, we made a decision with Catherine. There are two main reasons, but I already said we made the decision with Catherine to transmit
hand over
to transmit to our children, and it's a way. But it's very important because it's the decision we made to give the baton to our children, and at the same time, it's also a nice way for us to stay fully involved in the development of UTMB and help him and to help our children. So that is our choice, and that's why we are not thinking to sell UTMB business at anyone else.
That's great, because in fact we just have a precedent. I remember Andorra Ultra Trail just did exactly the same. They handed it over to Lydia, and because I was able to talk to Lydia at Transgran Canaria, she's fully now in charge. It's gonna be is it a heavy load for your children.
Since the very beginning we created UTMB, we decided to organize UTMB in 2002, and since the very beginning our daughter Isabel is involved in UTMB. Our son David is younger, and so he was just a teenager at the time when we created UTMB, but since he's an adult, he's also fully involved in the UTMB, and it's a very nice family story, and we just want to go on with this family story.
That's great. Okay. Okay. To finish, your resignation letter was sent last Saturday, but you chose not to send it to each and every member of the steering committee, as far as I understand. Is that correct? And if so, why?
I think that you have information that it should have been better that this information stayed inside the ISTRA steering committee. I disagree, but so no, I think we need to stay like this. I decided to resign, yes, for personal reasons, and that's all.
Okay, so... just to say farewell, Michel, it's your call. How would you like to be remembered after all these 7 years, after what a trip it has been, you know, building ITRA, you know, now the largest race database in the world, the largest trail runner database in the world, a global insurance that I have taken myself to travel to Chamonix in the last years. Out of all that, how would you like to be remembered? As president of ITRA, of course. The presidency of Michel was boom.
I don't know. I don't know. It's not my. It's not the question that I don't care about what people will think about me, about what I did, but it's not my style. People will think what they want to think, but I think I've not particularly. My ego is not so high that it's a thing I want to think about. No, we'll see. We'll see. I was really happy to do what I did for 7 years. I did this only by passion because it was my passion. So maybe if people recognize that, it's a good thing for me.
Okay, well, merci de votre attention, monsieur. C'est un plaisir de parler avec vous. Pardonnez ma français. Excuse my French. I wish I were more fluent on it. And I really appreciate you taking the time from confinement to share with us. Okay, and hope to see you in Chamonix once again this summer.
Okay, so merci beaucoup.
Okay.